We can use the XIRR function to work it out our CAGR. We just have to set up some cells just to help Excel out. So what we know is we want to turn 10 million into 17.5 million. Now for IRR or XIRR, you cannot have two positive numbers. There has to at least be one negative, one positive. So I'm going to just make that one a negative. And because we're going to use the XIRR function, we need to give it dates. So I'm going to say this 10 million is going to be at that date, and this 17 million is going to be at that date. Now that we've set it up and we've got our cells, what we now can do is we can use the XIRR function, tell it where the values is, those two there, tell it where the dates are, those two there. And when I say OK, you'll see it gives me 20.49%. Now this is slightly different from our other CAGRs, and that's because this is a lot more accurate in the sense that it's working out exactly the number of days in these periods, whereas our other CAGRs, which we can prove here, are working out on just single years. In order to prove this one, we'd then have to work out exactly the number of days per year. But XIRR is a very good way of showing how we can take one number and convert it into another number. And just by entering the dates between those two numbers, we'll get an accurate reflection of what the compound annual growth rate needs to be.